Why do ads follow you around? Let's assume you are purchasing a shirt from a web-based dress store.
You move a red shirt into your shopping basket. At that point, you rule against it and do not feel like buying it anymore. You have left the store, yet the red shirt is following you. Days after, when you are browsing your Facebook account, you see that red shirt again.
But how did Facebook know? Welcome back to Thought Control, and today we are going to discuss
why do ads follow you around?
The phenomena is called behavioral retargeting.
Advertisers have used it for at least 7 years and is now growing increasingly popular as tracking technologies improve and companies spend more money advertising on online.
For advertisers, it's almost like a home run. Most businessmen famously said, "Half the money I spend on advertising is wasted. The trouble is, I don't know which half."
Retargeting eliminates the waste, or at least tries to, by advertising only to people who they know are interested in their products.
Once a store knows you once, you were interested in that shirt, it won't harm anyone if you get a gentle reminder of it. On an average, you see around 1500 ads every day and ignore them all. But if you like that shirt and they know that you like it, now Facebook also knows about it. But the question is how? And also, do you have any problem with it?
Here is the manner by which retargeting works. Each time you visit a website, it drops something many refer to as a cookie onto your web program. That cookie, which can remain for as long as a month, is unknown. The site does not have a clue what your identity is or anything about you. However, it realizes that you saw that shirt. At that point, the web page can buy promotions through various retargeting organizations going about as agents, selling the advertisement focus on you, the mysterious customer, for the benefit of news sites, blog, and even Facebook.
So how do these stalker ads work?
Tracking technologies like web cookies are collecting information about our browsing activities from site to site. Marketers and ad tech companies compile that data to target us across our devices. And trackers are now so sophisticated that they can see when you are thinking about buying something but don't follow through. So they tell the ads to chase you around so you make the purchase. Then again, these unpleasant promotions can be very irritating, particularly when they make wrong suspicions. They are another example alongside repulsive autoplay recordings and video assuming control over internet comments. Stalker advertisement likewise raised security concern. A 2012 study by Pew Research Centre found that 68% of web users didn't like that fact that you are being tracked and analyzed, which makes them more uncomfortable. Your browser history can uncover a ton about you, including your medical problems, political affiliations, and sexual habits.
How can we stop these ads from following us everywhere?
Of course, it's a deal to get a deal on something you plan to purchase in any case. Yet not every person values being chased after the web by promotions, despite the fact that you are rarely identified. It's particularly alarming when you see these promotions on site where you store individual data, for example, Facebook, LinkedIn, or Google. In case you are worried about online security and might want to prevent sites from having the option to retarget you, there are some basic approaches to do it.
Number 1. Get an ad blocker.
You can keep advertisements from appearing on the sites you visit by using an ad blocker, which is a basic programming application that blocks sites from sending advertisements to you. Each internet browser has an advertisement block extension available, and the most used is Adblock Plus.
Go incognito.
Most programs have an in-secret or private web mode that you can go into to keep cookies from being stored away while you use the internet.
Number 3. Turn off your cookies.
You can set your internet browser to not accept the cookies. All the significant internet browsers have this alternative accessible in the settings. Yet remember that using cookies implies that will be logged from your email and web-based media accounts, just as giving memory element of what you have done on destination previously. An option is to physically erase the browser cookies once every few days.
Opt out of ads of Google.
If you use Google, you have some command over quitting promotions. Quit from your ad setting page. The interaction works across all gadgets that are signed into similar Google accounts. However, it will just impair personalized advertisements in explicit situations. It will probably take you a couple of hours to set yourself up to prevent ads from haunting you, and gradually you can make all the changes to your devices and internet accounts. It is a grueling process,
but you will be happy with the results. Those red shirts, ads that once followed you, they'll be gone. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any feedback, please let us know in the comment section below. And if you want to suggest any topic, please do. We'll love to make something on your choice. Bye bye, Tata, Assalam.